some very important practical information in this video. No hard dates, okay? We're not going to set dates, specific dates. However, I will talk about September, and we need to do another big push in September. There's no doubt about it. So I've already started that. September 2nd, it's time to put on a big, big push all through September. And be in good shape towards the end of September. Make a push, a big push here. And we will certainly encourage you to do that. As you know, the world is going in a certain direction very fast, okay? Now, the world, there's two different sides. One believes the world is going in the direction of triumph. The other believes the world is going in the direction of catastrophe. And these two camps are a universe apart. They're an entire belief system apart. Even more than a universe. They're an entire belief system apart. And changing belief systems is a very difficult thing to do. It takes a lifetime to change a belief system, so to speak. You really have to work at it. So we have two camps here, two different belief systems, both of them very strong and self-defined, all right? And then we have the ego saying, well, you have both belief systems, which would just be complete chaos and non-definition of anything. That's not it. So we have one group that says we're going towards great triumph, other great disaster, great catastrophe. Okay. The two don't see eye to eye. They will not see eye to eye. Because trying to blend both of them into some neutral, non-belief state is, that's even worse. So we just have to find out who's right. We'll find out, time will tell who's right. But those who believe that we're headed towards catastrophe, of course they're going to pick up and leave. Absolutely. And those who are headed to triumph simply cannot understand that. They think that people are absolutely crazy. Why would you want to leave when we're on the verge of triumph? That's right. Of course, that's nuts. Absolutely nuts. They think we're on the right on the verge of great triumph think people are absolutely nuts. And it's just that they're such losers that they can't stand living in triumph and victory or something. You know, there must be something very wrong with them. So that's the psychology of the moment that we live in. And I took a retreat, a vacation, away from the atmosphere of triumph. And then I came back into it. And I tell you, it's been the worst thing. It's like a death trap. Absolutely, the stress is just killer stress. Terrible. So, you know, you cannot go back into it as per. Once you leave, and then you let things play out. Now, if this world is going towards triumph, then I'll be the first to applaud when it reaches triumph, as it were. But I'm certainly not going to watch the game, all right? I remember last year, the Super Bowl, the 49ers, which are the Bay Area's team and the darlings of everybody, were in the Super Bowl. And I decided, you know what? I'm not going to watch the Super Bowl. I'm not going to watch. So I didn't watch. Did something else and didn't even listen to the radio. Nothing. You know, and I came back and I said, they're going to lose. I knew they were going to lose. Came back and what happened? Well, they lost. Barely. But they lost. I said, I knew they were going to lose. And I didn't get all this upset and turmoil and emotional roller coaster and all this kind of stuff, okay? So you place your bets and you take your chances and you have to, you know, commit to what you believe in. Otherwise, you're just going to be, you know, totally messed up. Now, I'm not saying for people who believe they're on the verge of triumph, for them to suddenly jump ship, It's not possible. They would feel all confused, etc. But neither am I saying that I should jump ship. Those who believe we're headed towards catastrophe, they shouldn't jump ship either. They should stay the course on what they're doing and let time tell. And then once we find out, you know, what really happened, then we'll sort out who has the wrong belief system and changes will have to be made, okay? But right now, it's no time to ask anybody to jump ship, and I'm not doing that at all. I'm preaching to the choir here, those who believe we're headed for catastrophe, headed for just severe troubles, actually. So we have to get in shape for what is coming. What is coming? And just coming back into this death trap of the Bay Area is a terrible place. I just say, oh my God, I got to get out of here. It is, the stress is just insane. The demands on your psyche are insane here. That's what it is. It's demands on your psyche that you fit into a certain role and a certain mindset of what? Triumph, of course. Silicon Valley is the heart and soul of the idea of triumph, that we're on the verge of triumphing and on the verge of some great, great, great breakthrough that's going to bring happiness, etc. So I don't fit here at all. Not at all. Not even the slightest bit do I fit in here. Never have. And it's just those who felt sorry for me, thinking they're doing me a favor by bringing me here, because they said, oh, you're in danger of missing out on the great, glorious breakthrough. And I said, no way, the world's headed for catastrophe. So again, totally different belief system, each one very, very self-contained. And that's fine, because if one of them's right, it should be self-contained. Whichever one is right should be very self-contained and not changing, absolutely. So we'll find out which belief system's right and which one's wrong. Okay, and we're not going to try to fudge it. We're going to get a clear delineation. It's necessary. So I don't want to stay here and try and, you know, muddy the waters and say, well, we're not really sure what happened, because let's have a clear outcome. Let's have a clear, clean outcome. Find out what's what. So again, don't watch the game. Don't need to. It's only the outcome that's important. It's only the outcome. And the question is, who's in bliss? Who has dropped fear? Who has dropped fear? Who has dropped fear? Which belief system leads to dropping fear? Is the question, right? You know, nobody wants to live in fear. So the idea is that we're on the verge of a great triumph over fear on this planet. That's the ones who think, you know, great triumph. I say, no, we're on the verge of a great collapse into fear, into a black hole of fear. Trying to build upon a foundation of fear, which is never going to be stable. It doesn't get rid of fear. It only leads to seeking other triumphs. It's a constant process of trying to triumph, whereas the belief system that leads to bliss, that's the final triumph that ends it. That ends it. It's the there's not another and another and another and another and another, so to speak. One minute, please. We're living here in the Silicon Valley, and people don't agree with this belief system here. They're all into greed, money, power, success, control, triumph, thinking that their enemies will be vanquished. The real enemy we have, my belief system is, the real enemy we have is the continuity problem. Without that problem, we would drop all this instantly. Guaranteed. That's my belief. And the Holy Spirit solves the continuity problem. Silicon Valley's not going to solve the continuity problem. Okay? if you know what the continuity problem is, there's no way in the world that all this effort in the world solves a continuity problem. It only makes it worse, or it perpetuates it. And we'll build it up even worse for us. But the Holy Spirit's solution, perfect solution, doesn't matter how bad it is. It solves it perfectly. So, there has to be this parting of the ways. You either watch the Super Bowl or you don't. Okay? It's like that. You know, a lot of people think the Super Bowl is the greatest thing in the world. All the commercials, I mean, for me, it's the most violent, degrading, mind-warping, distorting, agitating, horrible, horrible, horrible thing in the world. You know, the Super Bowl, just awful. And basically, we're headed towards the global Super Bowl, the planetary Super Bowl, the big contest. You know, as it were, who's going, good and evil? No. There's no triumph like that. You don't triumph over the continuity problem in that way at all. The Holy Spirit has already placed within our minds the answer to the continuity problem. It's this bliss. It's this perfect lack of evidence of any loss of identity at all. It's a vision. That's how the continuity problem is solved. So, again, these two belief systems are utterly foreign to one another. You can't mix them together. If you mix them together, you get utter confusion, because they're mutual exclusives. They're basically mutual exclusives, really. Two different directions going the opposite direction. Totally different remedies are being pursued, all right? And the concern is, well, maybe they'll succeed in making this world an incredibly beautiful place and everybody will want to live here, et cetera, et cetera. But has the continuity problem been solved? And, of course, they will say, well, it's been solved because you don't want to go home anymore. We've made the world so nice, you don't need to go home. Or living in such a beautiful world does solve the continuity problem. And I say, no. No, no, no. The continuity problem is way, way vaster than what they're talking about. The solution has to be a completely profound solution. It has to be an entire blanket solution. It has to be a completely seamless solution. And it has to be a solution that everybody has equally, that was bestowed equally on everyone. There's a lot of different, you know, parameters that have to be met. The metrics of the solution are very, very, very profound. And the Holy Spirit beats those parameters, absolutely. But just trying to social engineer a quote-unquote better world, that doesn't even come remotely. It's not even remotely, not even faintly close to what we need as far as a solution to the continuity problem. So there's these, okay, so we have this separation. Parting of the ways, parting of the destiny paths. It's simply that you say, we're not going to watch the Super Bowl. And, you know, we'll find out who wins, of course. We'll check the paper, as it were. But we're not going to watch it. We're not interested. It doesn't matter who wins the Super Bowl, as it was. It doesn't matter who comes out on top in this world. It doesn't matter. Because that's not a solution to the continuity problem. They will claim it is, because they say now the right people are in charge. And we'll be able to now, you know, all go in the right direction and solve the continuity problem. No, it's not true. We cannot solve the continuity problem for ourselves. That's the whole point of the Holy Spirit. God knows we can't do it ourselves. In the belief system that I have seen, the Holy Spirit has shown me, all of that is clear. It's all clear there, all of it. So, I would say the parting of the ways is likely to take place in September, is likely to take place, or at least the readiness needs to be there, because the Super Bowl is going to get started. The global Super Bowl, deciding, you know, who's going to triumph, who's going to be in charge of the future of this planet. It doesn't matter, who's in charge of this planet at all. It doesn't solve the continuity problem at all. Not at all. So why watch the game? You're not going to learn anything. You're just going to get all completely agitated, you know. Of course, I had to hide the fact I didn't watch the game because everybody in the Bay Area watched the game, just about. And of course, everyone assumed I watched it. Everybody thought that I watched the game because how could I not watch the game? You know? And so I said, that's a real bummer they lost. You know, I was like, wow, I'm so down. I don't want to talk about it. I just shook my head and said, unbelievable. And that's it. I didn't get it because I didn't know what happened except that they, you know, barely lost at the end. So I just said, wow, I don't want to talk about it. I didn't watch it. So everybody assumes you're going to watch this global Super Bowl, this global conflict. Everybody assumes you're going to watch it. And so later on, they're going to say, wow, you know, unbelievable. I guess incredible. Huh? Well, this is terrible. What happened? It's just, I'll say, yeah. But at some point, I'll say, no, you know what? I didn't watch it. Didn't watch the train wreck. Yeah. It's like, let's just throw everything together. Let's see who comes out on top, and then we'll have a new champion. Can the champion solve the continuity problem for us? The answer is no. Only the Holy Spirit can. And the Holy Spirit is not in any competition whatsoever. The Holy Spirit is the triumph over the continuity problem. That's what it is. It is the triumph. So if you try to explain this to people who are believing in the triumph, they'll think you're completely nuts, and you need some kind of psychiatric care. You know, from their position, they're so into it's so important. Triumph is so important to them that they think that not believing in it is a sign of mental illness. That is how they believe. So. You know, I haven't found it helpful to try and explain to people that, yeah, you know, this is the parting of the destiny paths and everything. They just think you're completely nuts. So what's the use? You know, I didn't tell anybody I'm not going to view the Super Bowl. I didn't tell anyone. They all assumed I did, but did not. So I think everybody in the world just assumes that everybody in the world is going to watch this great conflict. Okay? This great contest. Not true. Though there'll be those who do not, and they will, where will they go? Maybe nobody knows. Nobody will be even paying attention where they go. But they'll go somewhere where, you know, there's no television sets, as it were, to watch the conflict. You know, metaphorically speaking, the conflict will not be an issue. They'll be out playing golf, as it were, metaphorically, and maybe literally, but not even watching. It doesn't matter. And if you watch, you'll get caught up in the belief that it matters, because there's all the commercials and all the cheerleaders and all the fans screaming, all the announcers and everything, the hype, you know, to pull you in to get you to watch. And it's a terrible exercise, actually. Terrible exercise. And it'll take people a long time to unwind from it, really. But hey, they got time. They got all the time they need. So September is the time again when we start focusing on bliss. Bliss is the triumph over the continuity problem. All right, start focusing on that, and just keep on getting in shape that way, and keep making a push. I know everybody's on edge right now. Of course. So you have to take a proactive approach right now. and saying, I'm focusing on blessing. Don't worry trying to explain to anybody else. It's not possible at this point in time. It's not possible. So, you know, again, self-defined, completely self-defined, and that's it. That's all there is to it. And again, one is right and the other is wrong, I'll tell you that. And so once the ones that are wrong find out that they were wrong, then they will say, oh boy, I need to change my belief system. So hey, if it turns out that the belief system that I have is wrong, I'll have to change, no doubt about it. And I know it can be done because I've already changed from one to the other. I already pulled myself out of this whole, you know, triumph belief system of the world. So it can be done. It takes a lifetime of effort, but it can be done. You know, 35, 40 years of effort can do it. So if I'm wrong, I'll have to change it. And yet if the others are wrong, they'll have to change. So, you know, chips are on the table. Let's find out, you know, who's right and who's wrong and go from there. Okay. Keep your focus. One more push. One more push. One more rally here. One more rally here. In September, we made the huge push in August, July, August, etc. One more push in September now. One more push. I got to do it too. We all got to do it. Practice sidestepping. You know, instead of going straight forward, practice sidestepping. Instead of jogging in a straight forward, if whatever you do, practice moving to the side. If you do exercises, practice movements laterally instead of just forward, 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 like a football game. We got to go forward, 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 touchdown. No, practice going off to on the sidelines, running out of bounds on the sidelines. Okay, lateral movement, lateral movement, lateral movement is a very good thing to practice right now. Okay, a lot of reinforcement and reassurance is coming your way this September, and we'll get the job done for sure. All right, that's it for this one.